And we're gonna have to do everything over here.
And as Dominicans,
every time we place ourselves before the Eucharist, before the Blessed Sacrament, we say a prayer, O sacred banquet, in which Christ becomes our food, the memory of his passion is celebrated, the soul is filled with grace, and the pledge of future glory is given to us.
Everyone who came to Babette's feast, they ate this food of her complete loving sacrifice for them. And their hope was renewed. It had been on the wane, you know. They'd started to fall into a kind of bitterness, kind of pettiness, a kind of stingy living, kind of becoming like annoyed and snipey. But what Babette made for them, it just opened them up in the way that the Eucharist does for the saints.
Yeah, and one thing, having just seen this film 30 minutes ago, I think there are a lot of symbols, and they all point towards the Eucharistic sacrifice and the immense perfect love that we receive anytime we receive the Eucharist as Catholics. But there's also so many distractions that these guests bring with them to the table. And those distractions, those doubts, those words of defamation towards their neighbor, and even their own, you know, self-loathing, seems to dissolve at the end, where they have to surrender themselves at the table, and they also have to be able to receive that gift and see how it transforms them. And that's the resolution that we get at the end, is that having not seen the source of this meal, having not even been able to fully appreciate or even understand what sort of sacrifice was made, they knew full well that they were receiving some sort of gift of love. And that transforms them. And it causes them to reconcile themselves with each other, but then also depart in as a better half, as a better person, somebody who has experienced that immense perfect love.
So, what would it mean for your Thanksgiving?
As you're getting ready for this big feast, think of the feast of our Lord that he invites us to every time we come to Mass. Every time we may have our own doubts and we have our own reservations, that the Lord is present there. And to even make little acts of Thanksgiving means that we can see that there's something and someone higher than ourselves, and that they deserve that thanks and they deserve that glory.
Thanksgiving, I would say this, bring something to the table that is a token of your own giving thanks. So if that's volunteering to set the table, if that's making the cranberry sauce,
rearranging the candy corns.
Okay.
Opening the bottles.
Yeah, okay, even if that's what you can muster. But as long as you do it with love, you know, you contribute somehow to the feast. You know, sometimes it's kind of annoying, you know, when you hear people say, you know, I don't get anything out of Mass. What would you bring to it? You know, what do you bring? There's the offertory, and those two elderly sisters in Babette's feast, what they brought to the feast was their charity. They did not understand what Babette was doing, but they had the disposition of charity that allowed them to be open. They thought they were doing something out of love and patience for her way of doing things, and then they were then able to receive. So they knew the practices and the habits of charity. And we should have that with us as we approach the table as well. And especially to be helpful. You know, that's one thing. I think that the point isn't made often. The saints were always helpful. Very simple. The saints were always helpful. So bring love to your thanksgiving and know that you've been fed by the food of charity, which is the banquet of the Lord's body and blood. And for that, we should be thankful.
Did it record, Father? It did.